Circular lamina problem. So first problem is circular lamina 50 mm diameter is standing on one of its on the rim on HP. Okay, and the lamina inclined at 45 degree to HP, the diameter right angles to the diameter which is passing through the point on which lamina rest is parallel to VP. So draw the projection of the lamina. See, first we'll go for what is the resting position. So resting position, resting on HP first. Okay, next is lamina is inclined to HP. Okay, these two are very, very important. So resting on HP and lamina is inclined to HP. Okay, so first I'll take lamina 50 mm diameter is resting on HP, means it is in top view. So I'll take 50 mm diameter is given, so I'll take 25 mm radius. So we'll take 25 radius. Okay. So from the center, draw one circle. Draw one circle. So next, divide this into a exactly 8. Parts. So I have divided into a 4 parts. So next, exactly divide this into 8. Okay, next, see, if you want to divide, you draw 45 degree line from this box and again 45 degree line from this box, you will get it and circle is exactly divided. So next, do the naming. So this is A, this one is B, this is C, this one is D, and this is E, F, G, next H. Okay, so after that, draw projection line upward. So draw projection line upward, next from here, next from here, next from here, next from here. Okay, so next do the naming. This is a visible line, so we'll make it visible. Okay, do the naming. So this is your A dash and this is B is visible, H is not visible. Okay, so that's why B dash and in the bracket H dash. Next, C is visible, G is not visible, so C dash in the bracket G dash. Next, D is visible but F is not visible, so I will take it in bracket F dash, and this is E dash. Okay, why I am mentioning in the dashes? Because this is a front view and this is a top view. Okay, so this is a front view and top view, and this complete is called as a surface of lamina. This is complete is called as lamina, surface of lamina. Okay, so this is the first step of the problem, and show the dimension. So this is very important. Okay, show the dimension. So how much it is? It is around 50 mm diameter. Okay, so this is the first position. So after that, you need to go for the lamina inclined 45 degree to HP. So this is the surface of lamina. This lamina is inclined 45 degree to HP. Okay, so take protractor. Okay, take protractor from this and take 45 degree. Okay, so take 45 degree, draw 45 degree line. Draw 45 degree line. After that, measure from A to E, then from this point cut an arc. Okay, so this point is your A dash and this point is your E dash. Okay, after that you wanted to place B and H dash, C dash, G dash, D dash and F dash. So first I'll measure from A to B dash. So A to B dash will cut. Next I will measure from A to C dash and G dash. A to C dash and G dash I'll cut. Again, I'll measure from A to D dash. Okay, A to D dash, and I'll cut. Okay, then do the naming. So this is your B dash and H dash. This is your C dash and G dash. This is your D dash and F dash. Okay, and make it visible. So this is a visible line. Okay, show the angle. Here it is a 45 degree to HP. Okay, so after that, draw projection line downward. So from here, okay, so don't draw extra line, so unnecessary line, draw from here up to, okay, so this is your A, okay, next from here, okay, so this is your A, and this is your B, and this is your H. So next, from C dash and G dash, so this is your G, and this is your B. Next from here you draw, okay, so this is your H, and this is your B, this is your C, and next this is your G. Okay, next draw it from D dash and F dash, so from here, okay, and see, this is your F, and this is your D. Next from E, E is here, draw, okay, this is your E, okay, nah? So next, draw freehand sketch, okay, so it is a use freehand sketch. So this is your freehand sketch. Okay. So in computer you can do ellipse. Okay. But here you can't. So this is your second position. So what is the third position? So third position is given diameter, right angles to the diameter, which is passing through the point on which lamina rest is parallel to VP. So this is your diameter, right? So this is your diameter, but the diameter is right angles to the another diameter. So means this is your right angles to the diameter, but so diameter right angles to the diameter. So this is one diameter and this is other diameter. This is right angles to it, and which is passing through the point. Which is passing through the point means this is a point is lamina rest. Means this is the lamina rest. Okay, so this should be placed on where? On XY line. Okay, so you take E is on XY line and you can construct it so that you can make it parallel, diameter is parallel to both the plane. Okay, so please understand, diameter, right angles to the diameter. See, this is a one diameter and this is other diameter. So, right angles to the diameter which is passing through the point. Means, which is passing through the point and which lamina rest. See, this is a resting lamina. So, diameter is passing through that point. Means the point E should be placed on where? On XY line. If you place it on XY line, so the diameter is makes parallel. Okay, so we'll construct now. Okay, so for constructing, before that I'll draw one box for the apparent length of, apparent position of circular lamina. I'll draw one box. Okay, so next extend it downward, and here also extend it. See, and then we take this is a 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, next I'll take this is 5, and this one is 6, and this one is 7, and this one is 8. Okay, see how to place this is on XY line. So I'll take 2 and 3 line. Okay, and before that, this is a upper end view, and here surface of lamina is inclined to HP. Okay, so this is upper end view. So now take upper end view to place here. Okay, so I'll take 2 and 3. So I'll measure 2 and 3 first. I'll measure 2 and 3 and I'll place here. Okay, so this is, I'll take 3 and this is good. Okay, so from 2 and 3 you draw one perpendicular line downward. Okay, and here from here also draw one perpendicular line. After that, measure from 3 to 4. So this will be equal to 2 to 1. Okay, so I measured and I'll cut an arc on the line. Okay, from point 2 and from point 3. Okay, na? So this point is, if you are rotating like this, means this is a 4 and this one is a 1. So draw box. Okay, so box is completed. So next, you wanted to place E, right? So measure from 2 to E. Okay, 2 to E. From 2 to E. Measure it. So this is your E. The naming should be below XY line. So if it is above XY line, it is a front view. So that's why naming should be below XY line. Again, from the 2 to E, and this is equal to 1 to A. Okay. So again, from 1, cut an arc. Okay. So this is your A. So I'll draw one small line. Okay. Straight line. Okay. Na? So next, I wanted to place C and G. So I'll measure from 2 to C. 2 to C. So which is equal to 3 to G. Okay. So from 2 to C. 2 to C. Next I'll do it from 3 to G. So I'll do the naming. So this is your C and this is your G. Okay. So next you wanted to place B, D, F, H. Okay, so for placing that, I'll measure from 1 to 6. Okay, 1 to 6. This is on 1 to 4 line. So this is your 1 to 4 line. I'll measure from here 1 to 6 and cut an arc. Again, similarly, so 4 to 5 is both same. So I'll measure and we'll cut an arc from here. Okay, so next, this is your 6 and this one is your 5. Okay, next I wanted to place 7 and 8. I'll tell you why it is required. Okay, so 7 and 8. So from 1 to 7 you measure, and this will be equal to 2 to 8. Okay, 1 to 7, and then from this side 2 to 8. So draw perpendicular line from this. Perpendicular line. Yeah, I have drawn now. See, now you can place very easily. So this is your A. So where is B? So this is the B, and this is your C, and this is your what? D. And next, this is your E, and this is your what? F. And this is G, and this is your H. Okay, so now you have placed the points very easily. So now, you know, draw freehand sketch. Draw freehand sketch. So now I have drawn. Okay, so this is the, and here you have to understand, see, diameter from E to G is, from ear to ear, is parallel to XY line. So it is parallel to VP. Your condition is satisfied. The laminar rest on VP is parallel to VP. So this condition is satisfied. Next, draw projection line upward and complete the profile. So E, from, I'll start from A. Okay, A is on XY line. A is on XY line, so this is your A dash. Next, I will start from B. So B is little above XY line. Okay, so here, okay, so this is your B. Okay, and then you'll get H, is both are in same line. So this is your B dash, and this is your H dash. Next, I'll start from C. I'll start from C. So C is a little above XY line, and see, this is a C. Okay, again G, both are in same line. So this is your C dash, and this is your G dash. Next, D and F. D and F, so this is your F, and this is your D, and this is D dash, and this one is F dash. Next, E. Okay, so E, this is your E, this is your E dash. Okay, so what is the next step? Again, draw freehand sketch. Freehand sketch. Okay, so this completes your problem. So you have to make parallel to both the plane. So I have made it. See, it is parallel to XY line. Okay, so this completes your problem, and this is the final position. Here you have to write all dimensions are in mm. Okay.